Good morning or good afternoon. My name is Steve Austin and I am a professional dog trainer. These days, my dogs are being used mostly in conservation work. I have done Macquarie Island. We use the dogs to find the last remaining rabbits, rats and mice on Macquarie Island, which is a World Heritage Island. Just recently completed Lord Howe Island, which is another World Heritage Island, and using the dogs now to find the last remaining rat and also making sure that nothing else comes onto the island. Just recently, and only a few days ago, just did Moreton Island for cane toad. We train dogs to find endangered species, plants, endangered plants, invasive plants. Hawkweed was another great one for, we did that for New South Wales Parks and Wildlife. A lot of feral cat work, a lot of feral fox work, of course. So we're doing all sorts of conservation work for many different government agencies. The subject today that I've asked me to speak about is the urban fox. I believe there are two foxes. There's the urban fox and there's the rural fox. And the two foxes, behavioural-wise, are very different, causing exactly the same damage to our wildlife, but very different in the way I handle them in these areas. With the rural fox, I use a lot of trapping, leg hole traps, a lot of calling, and den fumigation by using the dogs to find the dens and then we fumigate. With the urban fox, it's a bit of a change in that sort of scenario. Some of the factors I've used urban foxes for is in zoos in particular, where they're getting in, herding the animals, areas where they destroy and kill wildlife around homes, acreages, etc., chicken houses, chicken places, and, you know, those sorts of situations there about the urban area. Now, when I do urban foxes, one thing I've found to be very useful is the setup, what I call set up the furniture and leave the furniture there. In this case, the furniture is a walk-in trap. I don't use leg hole traps around urban areas because of dogs and other animals, but I think a key factor that I have a lot of success with is I set the trap, wire the trap up, and I leave it in that area. So it becomes furniture if and when a fox comes into the area. So if you can imagine a zoo, instead of setting the walking trap up when they see on camera the fox or they smell the fox and then set the trap off, set the walking trap up, it becomes quite clear to that fox it's new. However, if you are proactive in setting the trap and not reactive, setting up a walk-in trap first and leaving it there for months and months and months and assume at some point a fox will come. It's very easy to set up. You can put a sand trap for the tracks in front of it or, even better, a camera. And when you start to see the fox come around, then I start to bait the trap. Now, I don't set it off yet. I bait the trap up usually with chicken wing or chicken leg. Not a lot, just a small amount. Get the dog, the fox, very confident, extremely confident about coming around and setting it up so the fox assumes there's always going to be good food around. Now, this is really important because you don't want the fox thinking, I'm going to go into the trap immediately. They come around, they might knock it, it might set off, and the fox gets scared and runs away. So I wire that trap up, put bait in and around it, get the fox extremely confident, and when I find the fox is confident, then I set the trap. So it goes off, put the bait in, and it's been a very good way that I can get these urban foxes in and very confident. I've caught, just this year alone, around where I live on acreages, I've caught 8 foxes in around about 3 months, and it's a very good way of doing it. The other thing I find about the urban fox is that they are very much a creature of habit. If you start to bait the fox up with good food, the food will always be in the same spot. You can actually get the fox to come expecting food to be there. I found this out because you'll often see urban fox around garbage bins or places where there's food left over. I've often see foxes around parks where a picnic had been held at night. They'll come around quite readily. So therefore, if you're setting that trap, it's always a good idea to make sure that that fox is happy to come around, and the behaviour that you've got to try and get into these urban foxes is one of that they're very confident and very willing to come in close to that trap. So I suppose, ladies and gentlemen, in summary, the word proactive instead of reactive is really a key factor to the success that I've had with urban foxes. I always assume that a fox will turn up, particularly in an environment where, you know, I don't want foxes to be, obviously, you know, around homes and zoos and whatever. So set the traps up. The bigger the trap, the better. I would prefer to use a wild dog trap more than the common fox trap or cat trap. I always use a cage trap that the fox can see the other end of. I don't like the blocked in, or the trap that's got the end of it blocked in with a tin or something like that. I like to have it fully opened, and I like to put the make sure that the trap is always set correctly. Practice setting the trap properly. Practice tying it up so it can't go off. Remembering to put either a sand trap down in front for the prints, or better still, a camera, and that is a very good way of setting off and capturing the urban fox. If you need to use a dog to indicate any scats and so forth, particularly for a rural fox or a country fox, it's always a good idea that, because you know where to set the trap. But I certainly wouldn't have a dog around when you're setting around a urban fox trap, because that way they do get a little bit deterred, particularly if the dog is free. However, I have seen foxes walk up to my dog runs and the dogs have gone off really badly, and after about 5 or 6 times, you'll see the fox just come in and then completely ignore the dogs if they go off. Once the fox knows it can't be got to, it becomes extremely confident. So just briefly, thank you very much for listening. I hope I've been a help. Rural fox is entirely different, but the urban fox is a problem, and that's one way where I am very successful at capturing a lot of them. Thank you for your time, and I hope that the rest of the talk today is interesting and beneficial for all concerned.